Hey guys, Sifu Jason, and we're talking about one of my great, great passions in life, and that is boxing, and why you should consider it for a life discipline and a self-defense discipline. All right, number one, I'm gonna start with the self-defense side, go back to why it's a great life discipline too. Here's number one for self-defense. It always was. Today, everybody thinks it's a sport, and the trainers that looked at it as a self-defense system, like Jack Dempsey talked about in his book, right, in championship fighting, those guys are kind of gone, and so pretty much anyone that's doing it is doing it for sporting stuff. And you have young men leading young men. Like I always tell my son, you know, hey, we're all gonna do stupid stuff. Just try not to do stupid things fast, because that's when you're gonna have a real problem. So in this case, getting in there, getting into firefights is not a good idea, okay? So no gym wars. If you do join a boxing gym and they're throwing you in there and you guys are in gym wars all the time, that's not productive. That's like going to the gym, putting as much weight on the bar as you can possibly handle, and then trying to do the reps fast before you have any form. It's a recipe for disaster. There's a fine line between being tough and being stupid, and we never want to cross that line. So here's the case again about it being self-defense. It always was. If you treat it like that, it will be great for you. Now, the thing about it is that, first of all, you gotta throw punches with gloves on. If you're doing any sparring, you're gonna need 16-ounce gloves and mouthpiece, headgear, like also that sort of thing. But for training purposes, I use small bag gloves to protect my hands from cuts. I do not wrap my hands, and I've been boxing for 40 years. I know, I mean, it's roughly. I mean, I started boxing, hitting bags and whatever in 1981 and jumping rope and all that. And what, we had, you know, Journey's Escape came out, Crazy Train was out. You know, we had Rush was out, 2112, I think. You guys will know, check it out for me if I'm wrong. But we had some great music. Music today makes me want to hit stuff in a bad way. But seriously, been doing this a long time, and my hands are fine. My wrists are fine because I've been taught proper technique by guys who weren't trying to turn me into the next dude to beat Sugar Ray Leonard. I learned good technique. Old school boxing, bare knuckle boxing, fought with a different punching structure than we have today, because today it's so glove dominant, right? So like just here, if I'm punching, I'm looking to make three knuckle contact with my wrist straight. Now, there have been guys on my YouTube channel before, and I've seen some of the posts, you know, they're all getting bent out of shape. He doesn't know what he's talking about because boxers today punch like this. Yes, wrong. That's why they hurt themselves. I don't need to wrap my ankle to walk someplace. If I have to wrap my ankle to walk someplace, it's because I have an injured ankle. If I have to wrap my wrist, it's because my wrists are injured. If I punch correctly, I shouldn't be injuring myself. If you have a self-defense system that gives you permanent disabilities, think about that. That's pretty dumb, okay? So, good technique. If it's a self-defense system, it shouldn't be destructive. It should be productive. I'm still doing this, and you know, I'm getting up there in years, and I'm really enjoying it. I'm having a great time, and I love what I'm doing, okay? So, you can too, if you learn it the right way. No gym wars, good technique. Don't punch this way. Don't punch with the top two knuckles. Don't punch in ways that are gonna hurt your wrists. If you can't do it, you can't do it bare knuckle, you shouldn't be doing it. Which leads me to this. I wear small bag gloves to protect my knuckles from getting cut, because I don't want to walk around. I'm from the Northeast, by the way. And so when I was young, before I moved south, when I got smart and I was able, I moved south. We say I'm a Yankee by birth, Southerner by choice. And I had pretty dry skin because, you know, the winters were bad, and I'd get, you know, a lot of lacerations and small cuts. So, you know, bang, bang, bang. I've got to be careful. I'm not wearing those gloves to protect my knuckles from bad technique. Nor am I wearing those gloves to block punches, because in street fights, I'm not going to have the back of my hand blocking punches. So it's a self-defense system. Good technique. Don't rely on a glove in the gym. Okay? Second, another reason why it is an incredible self-defense, because nothing's better than a jab. A good jab is gonna solve a lot of problems in life for you. A good jab, middle of the face, bang! And that is just an underrated technique. Number two, good footwork. Boxing gets you fluid and it gets you mobile, okay? And I say number three, why it's a good self-defense technique, because it teaches you how to fight on the inside. It teaches you good infighting. Like you'll notice, I'm gonna use an infighter's crouch. So in other words, here's my basic long boxing stance, and then I should square up a bit more, okay? That's all I'm getting a little bit across. I'm bending over. It's an Invaluable Scouts. Remember, this isn't an instructional video as much as it's a rah-rah video. I'm trying to get you excited about boxing as I am, because I think it's good for you. And, you know, I just love talking about things that I love. So there you go. But if you're out here jabbing, crossing, whatever, and somebody gets too close, tries to grab you, you're in a crouch. You're not bending forward. You're not bowing over, and you're not squatting. It's an infighter's crouch. You'll see that in the associated video here, that I'm not bending forward. I'm in a crouch. So I'm able to push. I'm able to foul, right? Way back when, this is an old saying I had, boxing's a game. It's a violent game, but it's a game. But if you want to fight, brother, we can fight. And that's what I mean, headbutt. Notice my head position forms and elbows can come in, right? And I don't have to hit to the body. I can hit underneath to the groin. Those back is not letting me do that. But you can imagine. I mean, I can hit a guy in a bladder. I can headbutt. Right? Boom, boom, boom. I can finger and thumb. I could use those. And incidentally, like I know Jeet Kune Do, Wing Chun, some self-defense people will say, oh, just poke him in the eye. Yeah, that's going to work, but that's not the only thing you do, right? I mean, we're not Captain Jack Sparrow with just one bullet in our gun. We might poke him in the eye and then follow up. Don't expect one thing to stop him. Next, like I said, body. It teaches you to go to the body on the inside. You're a small target, boom, 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 and people can't keep up with you on the inside. That's another great thing about boxing, that there's a lot of body open to hit. For every inch of chin, there's a foot of body. In some places, there's more than that, especially in America today. So hit the body, pop, pop, pop. Plus, and learn to do it right with movement and with your hands in the right position, you can still hold and hit. The old school boxing stuff, London Prize Ring rules, incidentally, they had a lot of grappling in it. The guy that trained the last heavyweight champion, bare knuckle, that was John O'Sullivan. The guy that trained him was a guy named Muldoon, who was a Greco-Roman wrestler. He was a champion wrestler. And there was a lot of combination of the standing, grappling, and throwing, and hitting. And so boxing techniques change over the years, again, to be more glove dominant and to be more punching, knockout dominant. And so guys punch with haymakers more. They swing. But in real boxing, you don't swing, you punch. It's snappy. And be careful about your contact point. I know I'm trying to give you a rah-rah video, not too much instructional. I can't help myself. But those are big things for why it works for self-defense. All of those are things you know you need. And then it can be fairly cheap, right? You can, if you're someplace where you can't really get to a good school or whatever, you can hang a bag or get a floor bag, invest in it. It's worth it. And start working a bag. I've got some videos on here. Go work the heavy bag. Heavy bag's fantastic. Now, about a life skill. Here's the other thing that's so important, I think, as a life skill. And what's tearing America apart is why boxing can help America. Because getting punched in the face teaches you to grow up. Because it teaches you in a hurry that what I'm thinking about what I'm doing, what I'm thinking about reality, and reality are not always the same thing. And it's my job to adapt, not the world's. You know, I could sum up the entire woke movement in a single sentence, and that is, you need to stop forcing other people to do what you want them to do. That causes conflict. Boxing, find out, bah, I get punched in the face. I'm like, I was so sure of my superiority in my mind that this guy just hit me, and trust me, I've been around this game a long time. I've been punched by lots of people, right? And it's good for you. This is, wow, I didn't realize that that guy could hit me or something. It teaches you some respect, right? So that's what I was saying. It teaches you that I need to be worried about me, not everybody else. I need to stop trying to change the world and fix myself. I have enough trouble with myself, you know? So it teaches me some humility and some respect, getting punched in the face, and learning how to not get punched in the face, you know what I mean? And maybe another thing, a great life skill. It keeps you in shape. This is great stuff. Jumping rope, hitting the bag, doing mitt rounds, sparring with people. It's great stuff. Gets you in great shape. Again, I go back, the sparring and stuff. If you're in firefights because you got a bunch of knuckle-headed trainers in there, then they're competing still too, that's destructive, no good. I'm not talking about that. So it'll get you out of your head. Too many of us, especially young men, are hanging around, they're gaming. They're playing video games. And so, I mean, there's nothing evil about it, but there's evil in the way we can use things to escape reality, escape responsibility. get off your butt, get out there, get some exercise, right? I'm not gonna say something here about a certain virus that happened not too long ago. And I'm a simple man, and I saw numbers, and I saw numbers of people who really were obese had a serious problem with that particular thing that I will not name because YouTube will get all bent out of shape about it. Listen, I'm not making any comments about that, but just for your own self-worth, right? Get start sweating. Get in the game, man. Get moving, and it's a great life skill because it teaches you that you're not. Oh, I used to box, and I'd say I used to box. Well, now you're really out of shape and you can't do anything. Keep boxing. Keep your discipline. You know, I use this metaphor in so many times in life. Keep your hands up, right? Work off your jab. Keep the basics. You know, it's taught me a lot about business, taught me a lot about a lot of things in life. And again, not taking everything so personally that I just get into a fight trying to change everybody else. You stay more focused on what I'm doing, and I just kind of let that stuff go. So that's what I mean in terms of a great life skill. It teaches you to relax because getting punched in the face is humbling. Yeah, humbling. Anyway, and it gets you in better shape, gets you some exercise. And man, do we need exercise. So, one last thing with this is that I have a love for boxing, and it has been a real blessing for me in my life as a discipline. And so it's also a very easy way to learn how to defend yourself and to develop some character through, especially for young men. Like if you're watching this and you're at home and you're like, you know, I got a little brother or I got a teenage son or something like that, and they're having some problems, or maybe you're depressed and you're sitting around, you don't know what to do. You know, go get some exercise, man. If you need to, get a bag and start working out. But one of the best things is some interaction. It gets us to interact with people and it gets us out of our own head. That's what I mean in terms of what's wrong with the world is we're living in these devices, which are fantastic blessings in many ways, like this video, for example, but we stay in our own head too much and we're not really interacting. So this is a great thing. It sure beats the crap out of getting on a treadmill. I'm doing that. You know, get outside, get into a gym, start doing some workouts, and it's just huge. And I swear by this stuff. It's kept me sane. You know, it's helped me deal with stress, helped me deal with depression, helped me deal with pressures of life, and it will help you too. So again, it's great self-defense, great, great, great life skill, okay? And that's boxing for 101. It's not just a sport.